Now what is the logarithm? We are starting today the logarithm. Generally one question is asked from the logarithm in IIT main examination or advanced examination. Now we come to the properties of the logarithm. You know the log 1 is 0 on any base, whether it is less than 1 or greater than 1. Log 1 always is 0. Number 2, log A on the base A, whatever the value of A is 1. We know this property. Now third property is the log log M base A is equal to log A, so power N hai, so we have this, whatever the base may be. This is always holds good. Now if the log A ki power K hai, then this is log M, we divide the power of the base, power, divide the logarithm power of the base. This is the fourth rule. Now fifth rule is if the log M on the base A, here is B, then we can have base and power can be changed. This is the fifth property. Sixth property is that if the log M on the base A, if we change the base, then we have to, suppose we have K base, then we have to divide with the which we remove the base, we have to divide. This is the sixth property. What is the seventh property? You know. We have read in the 10th class. We know this. The log this is now. Suppose this is B base A into B into A, this is always 1. Similarly, log A, B, log B, C, log C, D, log D, E, and so on up to the log, when log comes to again A, again A, rabbit comes in, then this value is always 1. This is always 1. You remember these properties. Now we come to the eighth property. What is the eighth property? If log M on the base A is then log 1 upon M on the base A becomes minus 1. Minus 1 se divide karna padega. If you reverse this, we have to multiply with minus 1. Now again we come this, if the base is greater than 1, then log x greater than 1. Log x greater than 1, then x should be greater than A. If A is greater than 1, this quantity holds good. Otherwise, if it is reversed, in the case of this, you see log x greater than 1, if A is lies between 0 and A, this property is reversed, then x lies between the A and 0, where N 0, Now again you see here, if log x less than 1 on the base a, if base a lies between 0 and 1, then x is greater than a. You see here. Remember again, here property becomes reverse. Now its graph is decreasing like this. If a less than 1, a less than 1. If a greater than 1, then it is increasing function. Ye increasing function ho jata hai logarithm. A base greater than 1, then log x base greater than 1 hai, ya base jo hai less than lies between 0 and 1. You remember these properties. Now we come to the now some questions here. Now remember these properties. Logarithm we when calculated from the table, the base is always 10. That is called the general logarithm, or denoted by represented by log. If the base is e, which is, you know, lies between 2 and 3, then this we take L. We take this is L by L. This is represented by L. Logarithm we represent by small L. You otherwise log, if it's general, base is 10. Table overall maintained in the base 10. Now we take the logarithm of any quantity we know. We find out the characteristic decreasing by 1, and we see the fraction part in the table, and then we calculate the value of the logarithm. We know this. If we find the ND log, then we see the what are the characteristics. And put n plus 1. Now n plus 1, after calculating the from the table and taking anti logarithm the numbers, then we put the decimal after n plus 1 digit. If n is in characteristic in the logarithm. We calculate this, we have read in the 10th class. I'm not going in the detail, but I am impressed by this formula. Now you know that log 1 on any base, this is 0. Log a on the base is 1, whatever be the value of the a. Now this property, you know, if the power is n, we then multiply. If the power in the base, we then divide by. If the base is a and power is m, then they can be interchanged like this. Now you know, if you change the base k, then you have to divide with the a. We divide with the a, which are you with the base, previously base. We have divided by this on the changing base. We have changed the base k. Now this is the sixth property. Now seventh property is that log a b is equal to log b a is equal to 1. And similarly you multiply, and in the last it comes a, then this is equal to also 1. Now you see here, now you see here, if log a, then if you put this a, then base will come here. This is the ninth property, and now here is, if a is greater than 1, then log x greater than 1, then x is greater than a. If a log x less than 1, then x lies between 0 a. If a is greater than 1, this is greater than 1. And log x greater than 1, if the base lies 0 and 1, this is x lies between 0 and a. And log x less than 1 on the base a, then always x is greater than a. Just reverse properties. Now base is less than 1 or lies between 0 and 1, then we give this graph. This is decreasing function. Decreasing. And when the log base is greater than 1, then we give the graph this. Increasing function. This is increasing function. You remember again. Now we have come the questions we solved here. And now question number 1. If x is log 5 on the base 3, y is equal to log 25 on the base 17, then what is the relation between x and y? Whether y is greater than or the x is greater than. You see here, the base are greater than 1 in both the cases. So we cannot calculate, we first make the base equivalent. Now, take 1 upon log 3 on the base 5. Here will also do same. Then we will see what is the relation between x and y. You see here, we are making the base same. Now, this is the first question, log 5 on the base 3. Now we can this have 1 upon log base 5 log 3. We can put this, and this is given to us x. This is given to us x. And now make the base again equivalent log 2 5 17. You know we can write this 17 on the base 25. This is equal to y. When we take the base same, then we have this. We have this log 17. Here is 5. We will divide by 5. Then 2 will come up. We have this. Now we have base are same. Now base are same. Here 5. Here is 3. Now you see here is 3. This is less quantity. This is greater quantity. You see, this is greater quantity when upon log 17 on the base A, this is y beta 2. Now here you see here, this is a quantity less than. Now you see here, we can have again log 3 on the base 5 is equal to 1 upon x. And here we have log 17 on the y, 2 upon y. 2 upon y, you see here. Now, this is greater. This is less, this is greater. You see here. Because here is 17, here is 3. Therefore, we can say that 1 upon x less than 2 upon y. 2 upon y. You see here. 2 upon y. We again remove the 2. Remove 2. We have divided by 2. We go. Now this comes here. And here we bring the 2, then this can be written in this way. We can represent y 1 beta 2. Or say log 17 here is half power base A. This can be written in the base this. You know this. Now this can be represented by this. Now, what is this now? We have seen here, we have said this is 17. Now we know. We know now, now what represent here? What represent here? Log phi, we have represent this log by this. Now you see that 25, we are making the equal base, so then we have to put this 5 square, then remove this 5, we have to multiply by half. Multiply half, half will go up. This is the. Now, again, we are taking this half on this power. On this power. Now, this can be represented by half power. Also, you see here, half power can be, we can represent it. Now, this is what you see here, 1 upon x comes out less than 2 upon y. Or, here what we say, y is greater than, y less than 2x. Y is less than 2x. You see here, then y is less than x. 2x less than that, so 2x is greater than y, then x is greater than y beta 2. X is greater than y beta 2. This is the relation between x and y. You see, we are making the base same. We are making the base same. Then what we see? What we see, we are making the base same. Now you see here, we are making the base same, we have this, x is equal to 1 upon 3 on the base 5, then we can put in this way, again we can put in this way, now this is 5 square, if we remove the 5, then we have to divide by 2. Or say we have this. If we not we put here, we put here. Then what we get here, we can get here on the base 17 half power. This is equal to y. This is equal to y. Now what reverse them. Then y, x beta y is equal to log phi 17 half power. Now, this is the 1 upon y. Or here is 1 upon x, 3. If this is more than 3, then this quantity is greater. Therefore, we can say y, x beta y greater than 1 upon x, or x greater than y. This is the another relation between the x and y. X greater than y beta 2, x also greater than y, because we can write in this way, and half we remove, we can bring the power, we put the power half, this is 4.1, therefore, if we reverse, then what we get, If we reverse this, then we have the log 17 ki root power, root 17 on the base y is greater than this. Then we can say that 1 upon y is greater than 1 upon x, or x greater than y. This is the required relation between X and Y. This is the correct answer. Now we come to the question number 2. You see here, what are the number of the solution of this? You see, this can be written in this way. Question number two. Now, if we remove the base, then this can be written x plus 5 is equal to, in the question number 2 to the power 6 minus x. We can write in this way. Now, he gave how many are solutions there? Now, you know, this is a straight line, and this is a into 2 cubed exponential function. Now, minus x, here you see, we cannot connect the x, we can now take the graph. What is the graph of this? What is the graph? And what is the graph of this? We see how many points they are close. They cross. Then if they cross at m point, then m will be solution. Now we see here, this is line, what is this line? Put y is equal to x is equal to minus 5. If we put x is equal to 0, then this is 5. Then this is the equation to the y is equal to x plus 5. This is the equation passing through the 0, 5 and minus 5, 0. Put y is equal to 0, then this will pass. Put x is equal to 0, then this will pass. Now you know this is a function 2x. Through x, we put the infinity, then this becomes 0. Therefore, this is coming from infinity. And so, you see here. Now, before it, there is 2 to the power 6. Then this is more and more will go this, in this way. Now here, put x is equal to 0, then we get 2 to 6 power. Put x is equal to 0, then we have the 2 to 6 power here, you see. Put x is equal to 0, then this point lies on upper. Here is crossing point is 1. Here is crossing point is 1. Therefore, solution is 1. What is solution? You see, put the x is equal to 1, then we get y is equal to 6. Here we will get 2, 6, 2. If we have, these are not equal. They are not equal. If we put x is equal to 2, then what we get here? Here we will get 5, here we will get 2 to 6 power upon 2 ka square. That is 2 to 4 power, not 16. Here comes 5, here comes 16. The no equivalent, no point crossing here. Now put it, y is equal to, and now x is equal to 3. Put x is equal to 3. And what we get here, we get y is equal to 8. Here what we get, if we put x is equal to 3, what we get here, 2, 6, 2 to power 3, here we get 8 ka bhag diya, 64 means 8 aya. Here is also 8. So this point satisfied when the value of the x is 3 and y the value 8, then this is the value satisfied. Other rest are not satisfied with this. This will curve go up and here will go in this direction. Only the crossing point is 1. Therefore, the solution is 1. That is the 3, x value 3 satisfied. You see here, I like value 8 comes 8. You see here. Clear to now, I'm again repeating. Now, this is the relation And he find out the point of the intersection. What is the solution of this? Now what is the solution he asks us? Now what is the value we cannot find by this relation? We have to put this is equal to y is equal to this and y is equal to this, and where they meet, that will be the solution. Now you see, 2 man, its power comes from the infinity plus and infinity and goes in this way. And this is always positive quantity, this will go away. And the line is y is equal to x plus phi will go in this direction. They meet at this point, and this will meet on the y-axis at this point, 0 to 6 at x is equal to 0. Now, what is the solution this now? Now put y-x is equal to 1, this is not satisfied. This is not satisfied. If you put x is equal to 2 also, then these are not satisfied. If you put x is equal to 3, then this is satisfied. The 3 at is the point of intersection, only one point of intersection, rest is no point of intersection, therefore solution is 1. Solution in this case is 1. Solution is 1 in this case. Only 1. You see here. I explain the all the terms and all the questions related to this question. Now we come to the question number 3. Show that this log 3 lies in this interval. He says that log 3 on the base 20 lies 1 upon 2 and 1 upon 3. Now we see how this lies in this interval. We see here. Now we know now 20 is less than 27. We know this. Now take the point 3 power, here we take the power, 1 by 3 power, this is always less than this, then this is less than 3, this is less than 3. Now, if we take a log of both sides, then on the base 20, on the base 20, what we get? We get this 1 by 3 less than log 3 on the base. So therefore, this lowest value is this. You see 1 by 3 is less than log 3. Now we come again. Now we come again, the 20 is less than 27. Now we take 20 greater than 9, suppose. Then we take the half power. It's greater than 3. This is greater than 3. You see here, we know if 20 is greater than 9, then take the half power. Then this is greater than 3, and take the both side log on the base 20, what we get? We get half log 3 on the base 3. You see here. Now half is greater than this, then log 3 on the base 20 lies between 1 by 3 and 1 by 2. You see here, 20 is greater than 9, then half power greater than 3. Look, take the log on the base 20, we have this. then half is greater than log 3, and this quantity is less than half, therefore log 3 lies between 1 and half and 1 by 3. This lies. This is clear to the student. This is clear. Again, I am repeating. I am again repeating. Now you see. So that this lies in 1 by 2 and 1 by 3. So we know that 20 is less than 27. We know this. We know 20 is less than 27. I take the power 1 by 3. Then and take the logarithm. Take the logarithm on both sides. This is greater than 1, then 4, inequality will not change. Therefore, we can say that less than log 3. We have this. Log 3 is less than 1 by, log 3 11 by, 1 by 3 less than log 3. Now take again, 20 is greater than 9. Now, and take the half power. This is greater than log 3, and take the logarithm on the base 20. Here is 20 greater than 1 base, therefore inequality will not reverse. This will remain same, therefore this is quantity is what? You see, half greater than log 3. Log 3, then we see, can say that easily can say that half to greater than hai, or your quantity less than 1 by 3 hai. From this relation, then this lies in between 1 by 3 and 1 by 2. Now question number 4. Now what is the maximum and minimum value of this? This you see, half less than equal to, you see here, base is less than 1. We are given this, log x on the base 0.1. We are given. Then we know, he asked us what is the maximum or minimum value. Now, if you put this, this base is less than 1, therefore this inequality will be reversed. You know, log 0.1 or the 0.1 is one quantity, this is one. We can multiply this. Now you see here, half, we can put 0.1 half power on the base 1. We can put this here, also 0.1x. So here, the quantity is less than, then this quantity will be greater than this. This quantity will be greater than x. Because base is less than 1, the quantity, this inequality inverse it changed. The inequality will change because the base is 0.1, less than 1. Therefore, this quantity is greater than equal to x. Therefore, we can say this is less than equal to 0.1 half. This is greater, means x less than, or what say, x less than 1 upon root 2, 10. Less than equal to 10. Then you see here, so less than x, the maximum value 1 upon root 2 hogi. The maximum value, baki to less than hai, baki equal to hai, to x equal to 1 upon 10 is maximum value. This is maximum value. This is maximum value. Now you see, we are given this. We multiply this. This is 1. The log 0.1 on the base 0.1 means 1. Log A on the base A is 1. This is property. Then we have multiplied this. Now this power will go here. Now base is 0.1. less than 1, this will be reversed. The inequality will be reversed. Therefore, this is greater than this. Or x less than this, x less than equal to this, or maximum value will be 1 upon root 10. Otherwise, rest are x less than. Now we come to the second point. Point 1 less than equal to 2. We are given less than equal to 2. Now again you see here, log x point 1 less than equal to 2, matlab log point 1, point 1. What we will get the value of the x here, you see here point 1 ka whole square. Now this will change, the x greater than equal to point 1 ka whole square, x greater than equal to 1 upon 100. 1 upon 100, so therefore you are greater than, the minimum value is 1 by, minimum value what? X ki minimum value will be 1 by 100, because this is greater than, x is greater than and equal to. So therefore, the minimum value will be 1 by 100 and maximum value will be 1 upon root 10. This is the answer. This is clear to the student. Now we come to the question number 5. Prove that the log 7 on the base 2 is an irrational number. Suppose this is not a irrational number. Let it equal to P beta Q, where P, Q have no any common prime number, no related to prime number. Suppose P beta Q, this is a log 7 on the base 2, let P beta Q, rational number, suppose this is P beta Q, equal to P beta Q, rational, equal to this rational number, suppose. Now P and Q are related prime, having no common anything. Therefore, we see here, we will solve this in this way. Question number 5. Question number 5. You see, suppose log 7 on the base P beta Q and P Q are relative prime, having no common. Suppose this is rational number, suppose this is equal to P beta Q, irrational number, suppose, irrational number we have taken this. Now you see the 7 is equal to 2 P beta Q, remove the log, on base pe power chal jayegi. The powers will be go, this index will go to the power. Now we multiply power Q, here we will be P. So you see your right hand side is even number. You see 2 ki power P hai, prime P is prime number. So this is even number, right hand side is even number. Right hand side is even number. And you see here Q is prime number. Here is all number. Therefore, left hand side is all number. All number. You see, the contradiction is there. There is contradiction. In the right hand side, the even number comes. Or in the left hand side, the odd number comes. They cannot be equal. They cannot be equal because here is an odd number. The odd number power Q gives odd number. Even number ki power will give even number. This is not equal to. This cannot be equal. So this cannot be this equal. Therefore, cannot be rational number. Therefore, this is the log 7 on the base 2 is irrational number. Therefore, log 7 on the bar is therefore irrational number. Rational number. This is the solution to the question number 5. Clear to the student. Now I am again repeating. Suppose the log 7 on the base 2 is not irrational, this is rational. Suppose, let it P beta Q, where P, Q are prime relative to prime. Now, remove this base, we will have this. Now, power Q on both sides, here will cancel out, here will remain, 7Q. Now you see here, right hand side is power of even number ki power hai. Therefore, this is even number. But in the left hand side, 7 ki power q hai, the odd ki power q hai, then this is odd number. Then the odd number cannot be equal to even number. Therefore, contradiction. This cannot be this rational number. Therefore, log 7 on the base 2 is irrational number. This is the answer to the question number 5. Now we come to the question number 6. Now, what is here? Now we are given log 3 is equal to, is equal to 0.477. We are given this on the base 10. This is general logarithm. Now take the 3 power key 40 on the base t. We will have this is equal to what? Then we know this is equal to 40 into log 3 on the base 10. Therefore, we have to multiply 40 this quantity. We have to multiply because property what say the power is n, n is multiplied, then this is equal to this. Now 40 into this equal to this, multiply with the chart, 28, 0 ka 0, 2, 28 to 30, answer ka 30, 16, 18, 19. This is 1, 2, 3. Here is 19.08. We have this. Its value ye hai. Now take the anti-clockwise, anti-logarithm. Take the anti-logarithm. Then we, these are the 19 net integer. Here is the characteristic. Characteristic is 19. Then we have to put a, the decimal sign, decimal point after 19 plus 1, leaving the 90 plus 1, matlab 20 terms, 20 terms chhodne ke baad aayega, so therefore that there are 20 in, there are 20 integers. What is the digit? 20 integers. We have to put after n plus 1 in taking the anti-logarithm. Taking the anti-logarithm, we will have the point after 20, 19 plus 1, the 20 integers, digits. Integers or digits. Therefore, the 20 after 20, we will have to put the decimal. So digit is 20. Digits are, pure digit are 20. Rest is fractional. Now we are not discussing about the fractional. This you know. Now again I am repeating. Log 3 we are given this. Then log 3 ki 4 power will, this will be multiplied by this. We multiply this, we get 19.080. Now here you see the characteristic is 19. Now we take anti-log, then we have to put the decimal point after n 19 plus 1 terms. So, a 19 plus 1 terms will give us the digit 20. Therefore, that digit are 20. Now this is clear to the student. Now we come to the question number 7, last question. If log x minus 1 less than log 0.09 x minus 1, then x in which lies, give the interval. Give the interval. Here is x minus 1, here is x minus 1 ka on the base 0.09. On the base 0.09. Now this is given to us less than. Now you see here, make the base same. Make the base same. Here 0.3 ki power x minus 1. Or here is 0.09, the 3 ki square power x minus 1. Now you see we are given this less than this. Then what is the interval in which x lies? You see here. Now you see here. Now you see here. If you do remove this half, we have to divide. The log 0.3 x minus 1 less than log x minus 1 0.3 we have to divide by 2. Now this being on the left hand side, then what will become? This will become square. Here will become, this will become x minus 1. Now here will base is 0.3. Therefore this will in reverse. Therefore we can say that this is greater than x minus 1, because here is the base is 0.3 less than 1. The inequality will be inverse, reverse. The inequality will be reverse. What we get now? Here we get minus 2x plus 1 greater than x minus 1. We have x square minus 3x plus 2 greater than 0. Then what we get? Greater than 0. Then this is less than, x should be less than 1 or x greater than 2. This will be 2, because greater than 0, so greater than 2 means interval will be 2 infinity. Interval will lie in the 2 infinity. You see greater than 2 hai, because inequality will change. Here is this is 0.3 less. Therefore, here inequality will reverse in this case, you see here. So therefore, x whether is less than 1, x less than 1. If we take the less than 1, does not hold. Therefore, we cannot take less than 1. We can take greater than 1. We can take greater than 1. We can't define. If x less than 1, we can't define this logarithm, because the logarithm of the negative terms is not defined, is not irreducible. You remember. Therefore, we have to take x greater than 2. So therefore, interval is 2 infinity. This is the answer to the question number 7. The base is 0.3. You know that this will inequality will be reversed. Inequality will be changed. Therefore, this quantity we multiply this now. You have this power, so this quantity will be greater than this. And this greater than this, then greater than 0, then greater than 0, then this gives x less than 1. But this is not satisfied. X greater than less than 1 is not satisfied. Satisfied. because minus quantity is not defined. If x is equal to less than 1, not defined. So this is the answer. X greater than 2, or say, to infinity. If it is greater than 1, then also this is greater than 1, then this is also defined. Therefore, we can put also 1 infinity also, because taking the x is equal to greater than 1, this is positive quantity. They can, logarithm is defined in the positive quantity. Whatever the whatever the base may be, therefore the interval can solution, because if x is greater than 1, then this is defined. This is defined. Now we come to the define. Now suppose take the x is equal to 1 point. Suppose x is equal to 1.1. Then this is 0.3. Here is 0.1. You see here. Then what will be of square? Will be, this will be 0.01. Now you see, this is less than this point here, point one. So therefore, here this is not satisfied also. This will change. 0 point as in not less than this will be greater than. Reverse. Then what will be the value of this? Now what will be the 0.1? So when we get this 0.1, here becomes 0.01, here become 1, but here is 0.01 is not greater than 0.1. Therefore, this is also greater than 1 is not satisfied here also. Therefore, the correct solution is 2 infinity. Correct solution is 2 infinity, because this is not satisfied, because it will reverse, because base is 0.3. If we take x is equal to 1.1, this way will not satisfy 1 greater than 1, not because here is 0.01. Here is 0.01, and square means 0.01, but this is not reverse, because base are the same, therefore the base are the same. This is satisfied also, because this quantity is reverse to, this is greater than this on the base, is less than 1 hai, so this is cannot be greater than 0.1. This cannot be greater than 1. Therefore, this is not satisfied. Therefore, correct solution is 2 infinity. This is the answer to the question number 7. Now we take tomorrow the inverse trigonometry function.